church burst into flame. Are you all right?
Don't touch me.
But it's me, Beth. Your wife.
No, you're one of them. A devil.
He's delirious.
Lies! I saw the devil's sign.
What are you saying?
The green flash in the sky. His demons were here all along, in our hearts and souls, just waiting for a sign from him. And now they're destroying our world.
But they're not devils, they're Martians.
Listen, do you hear them drawing near in their search for the sinners? Feeding on the power of our fear and the evil within us. Incarnation of Satan's creation of all that we dread. When the demons arrive, those alive would be better off dead.
There must be something worth living for.
No, there is nothing.
There must be something worth trying for.
I don't believe it so.
Even something's worth dying for. If just one man could stand tall, there would be some hope for us all. Somewhere, somewhere in the spirit of man.
Domination of the earth is fading fast, and out of the confusion the chance has come at last to build a better future from the ashes of the past in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again. Just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. All over again. All over again. All over again. I've got a plan. Can't you just see it? Civilization starting all over again.
I stopped, staring towards the sound. It seemed as if that mighty desert of houses had found a voice for its fear and solitude. Desolating cry worked upon my mind. The wailing took possession of me. I was intensely weary, footsore, hungry, and thirsty. Why was I wandering alone in this city of the dead? Why was I alive when London was lying in state in its black shroud? I felt intolerably lonely, drifting from street to empty street, drawn inexorably towards that cry. I saw over the trees on Primrose Hill the fighting machine from which the howling came. I crossed Regent's Canal. There stood a second machine, upright, but as still as the first.
Oh.
The sound ceased. Suddenly the desolation, the solitude, became unendurable. While that voice sounded, London had still seemed alive. Now suddenly there was a change, the passing of something, and all that remained was this gaunt quiet. I scrambled up at the crest of Primrose Hill. The Martian's camp was below me. A mighty space it was. And scattered about it, in their overturned machines, were the Martians, dead, slain after all man's devices had failed by the humblest things upon the earth. Bacteria. Minute, invisible bacteria. Directly the invaders arrived and drank and fed. Our microscopic allies attacked them. From that moment, they were doomed.